With the latest Lumia flagship, Verizon looks to make up for lost time. But is there enough here to make the new phone a success? I'm Michael Fisher, this is Pocket Now, and this is our quick review of the Nokia Lumia 928. It's impossible to discuss the Lumia 928 without taking into account the trail blazed by its predecessors, particularly AT&T's Lumia 920. Indeed, the 920 is the basis for the 928, and here in the States, it's tempting to call the latter device simply Verizon's version of the 920. But there are significant changes here. We'll get into that in detail in a future comparison video. Follow us on social media and here on YouTube so you don't miss it. But for now, let's dive into what the Lumia 928 does and doesn't do well, starting with hardware. Under the hood, the Lumia 928 packs a familiar power plant, a Qualcomm Snapdragon S4 at 1.5 GHz backed up by a gig of RAM, alongside 32 gigs of onboard storage. Battery capacity is a fairly middle-of-the-road 2000 mAh, and wireless charging, a hallmark of the Lumia line, works as well as it ever has. In keeping with high-end Nokia and HTC trends, though, the battery's still not removable, and the storage is still not expandable. Fortunately, Nokia has managed to address one of the biggest black marks against previous models, the unit's mass. The 928 weighs in at a respectable 162 grams. Now, that's still heavier than its super light flagship competitors, but here the weight combines with Nokia's famously sturdy polycarbonate and the Gorilla Glass 2 display facing to lend the phone a decidedly high-end feel in the hand that's only moderately impacted by the glossy finish. We do wish there was a matte option in white, though. In terms of aesthetics, the 928 is a fairly typical modern slab. It's a little faster in terms of hardware design, its aggressive sharp corners contrasting with its pillowy backside, which balloons outward to 10.1 millimeters at its thickest point. The casing is adorned with some interesting flares, like the ever so slightly curved glass and the love it or hate it forehead bezel above the display. It also packs a busier backside than previous Lumias, with penetrations for the new Xenon camera flash and a rear-mounted speakerphone. We're not too pleased with the responsiveness or feel of the plastic side keys, and the top-mounted USB port is as weird as it was on the Samsung Focus. So there's ups and downs here. Probably the most visible change the 928 brings to the table, though, is the substitution of a 4.5-inch AMOLED display for its cousin's IPS LCD. Here, the change is welcome, at least in our view. While its dimensions, 15:9 aspect ratio, and 1280x768 resolution are all familiar, the 928's 334 pixels per inch kick out heavily saturated colors, with nearly perfect black reproduction. This serves Windows Phone 8's modern UI very well, the tiles seeming to float across an expanse of dark glass in the default color configuration. Even those who dislike the larger-than-life color tones of AMOLED will likely appreciate the added side visibility of the 928's panel. In terms of software, Windows Phone 8 purrs along fairly well on the 928. We were occasionally stymied by a hiccup or a stutter here and there, something we're not used to seeing from Microsoft's smooth and consistent OS. By and large, though, the experience is slick and stable. Verizon and Nokia have added their fair share of customization here, but it seems unfair to call it bloatware, as the titles are big-name apps that many users will find useful. In addition to ESPN, CNN, and the Weather Channel, Nokia has added many of its custom titles, Maps, City Lens, and Nokia Drive Plus Beta, with the entire Here suite available for download on the Windows App Store, or via the prominently displayed App Highlights Hub. This aggregator provides a Nokia-curated app shopping experience that does a good job of separating the wheat from the chaff in the Windows Store. We should also note here that a customer investing in a Verizon Wireless Windows phone today has a much larger selection of quality apps than he or she would have even half a year ago, with Pandora, Spotify, and even Instagram represented. Instagram via a hack, yes, but a good one. In many ways, it's never been a better time to own a Windows phone, and the 928 arrived on Verizon at the perfect moment to take advantage of that. We tested the Lumia 928 on Verizon Wireless over the course of 6 days between Long Island, New York, and the greater Boston, Massachusetts area. LTE speeds were good to excellent in areas we had coverage, though some more rural areas stymied even Verizon's efforts to provide ample 3G reception. Voice calling was a bit of a mixed bag. The callers said we sounded just so-so on their end, but on the plus side, noise cancellation was outstanding. We stood next to a moving train, literally, at one point, which the caller on the other end couldn't hear at all. We wish Nokia hadn't moved the speakerphone to the backside of the 928. Its repositioning doesn't result in clearer sound. And that's a shame, as we'd have liked some positive trade-off in exchange for dealing with yet another rear-firing speaker. That said, it's still plenty loud for media viewing and listening. And if you opt for the headphone route instead, you can use Nokia's simple equalizer software and Dolby headphone audio settings to hone your experience. Battery life was in line with most other Lumias, and slightly above average for a high-end smartphone. With moderate use, including a fair bit of wireless tethering and quite a bit of travel across areas with minimal or no service, the phone lasted us about 10 hours. More battery impressions in our written quick review at Pocket Now. Finally, the thing that makes a Lumia, the camera. We weren't expecting to see much improvement over the 920, and because the hardware is essentially identical, we didn't. But that doesn't mean the experience wasn't exemplary. The 928 continues to excel in low-light shots, and well-lit photos, particularly outdoors, often turn out even better. The Xenon flash is a nice add-on for those who like using the flash, but on the 928 it's so rarely necessary that it's almost an academic addition. The camera isn't perfect. Colors are occasionally a little washed out indoors, and we sometimes wish we could tweak its low-light settings to get more dramatic contrast. Also, Microsoft really needs to refit its viewfinder software to provide shooting mode indicators. But these are minor quibbles. Overall, the 928's camera is outstanding, easily topping nearly every other Windows phone and most other smartphones, period. The Lumia 928 is not the smartphone that's going to catapult Windows Phone to a massive gain in US market share. It's too mild, too iterative for that. But what it will do, and what it's already doing, is bringing what remains of the buzz surrounding the Lumia 920 to the nation's largest wireless carrier. Is it a little late? Yes. But is it a good thing? Also yes. We give the Nokia Lumia 928 an 8.3 out of 10. That's going to do it for the video portion of this quick review. Read the full text at pocketnow.com. Toss us a like if you did enjoy the video. Leave us a comment if you have a question, comment, or a suggestion. And please do subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.